Hey you guys, it's Megan, and today I'm bringing you my February empties. I am so excited for this video. I am so happy that I'm keeping on the monthly empties track, and let's hope and pray that I can keep it up throughout the rest of the year, because I've honestly felt like every month is almost like a project use it up or like a project pan or something, where I'm like, okay, let's try to finish up this, this, and this this month so my empties video doesn't suck. And it's been working. I feel like it's helped me work through more products. And so thank you guys for really encouraging me to do monthly empties, because I think it's helping me. First, I wanted to just give note and shout out my sparkly ass eyeshadow. Oh my God, my subby Wendy. Hey Wendy, she sent me two Lemonhead glitters, and I've been talking about Lemonhead glitters, and she so generously offered to send them to my P.O. box, and I was just like, oh my God, like this is like a dream come true. So she sent me Jailbait in this like adorable little sample thing, oh my God, and I'm wearing it on my lids today. I'm sure you can see the magical disco ballness of this shade, and it's like, I don't know, it's kind of like a chartreuse, like olive green, like antique-y gold color, definitely more green than anything, and it's so stunning, and I love that it's like a paste, so it's glitter suspended in like a cream or gel or something, but it's completely a clear base, and so all you see is the glitter, and I just applied it with my finger, and I'm just like amazed. And then she like totally shocked me and sent me a really, really generous sample of this glitter that was called like Midnight something. I have to reread her sweet letter, but this is like a silver with holographic glitters. Like I just need some. I think I'm going to wear this for the Lady Gaga Enigma concert that I'm going to. Oh my God, I can't wait for that in the summer. But this is just like the freaking most, this is the most, like the, I don't have words. I'm so happy. Thank you so, so, so much, Wendy. I just love it. And I will definitely have fun playing around with these, and maybe I'll do like a get ready with me featuring at least the Jailbait color, because I just, if you love glitter, this is a really cool brand to check out. Okay, going into the empties. So I have some makeup-y fun stuff in here. This is making a mess. So my Aunt Sue gave them to me for Christmas. It's called the Pocket Palette. And so it's a three-step little system. It was a Kickstarter campaign. It's a female-owned company, and I was just like, so like, what is this? I never had heard of it before. And it has a BB cream, a lip and cheek color, and then a mini mascara. So the like idea of this is for it to be on the go for like if you take public transportation into like the city to work, or if you're just like in a rush and you have one of these little packets in your purse or back pocket or whatever, you can just pull it out and quickly apply some makeup. I like the concept. I think that the concept is really great, but I would say that there's a few problems with this, like what it currently is. I feel like they could definitely improve it. The BB cream I wish was a higher coverage like concealer instead of just like a super, super sheer coverage for all over your face. I feel like I would have gotten a lot more use out of this, and it would have made a bigger difference in how I looked if I could have just put like a little bit of coverage under my eyes, maybe a little on my cheeks or wherever I felt like I needed some coverage. But instead, this is just super sheer and didn't do much for me other than make me look really tan, because it's definitely more of a light to medium skin tone. So I don't know if there's different colors or if there's just one color for now, but I would say if they could do like a higher coverage concealer, that would be more useful and more like you could use it in different ways and not just have a sheer coverage. The lip and cheek color is the best part. However, the formula is so liquidy that it kind of like oozed everywhere. Like I didn't need to use all of it in here, but like look at that color. It's freaking gorgeous. And so you can just apply some of this on your lips and like blend it on your cheeks as like a little bit of color. Really pretty, but I feel like the formula is just too thin to have in this format. And then the mascara is really cool. It's literally just a little mascara wand that has product already on it. I thought that was a really cool concept. And even if they just sold like the mascara thing separately as like an on-the-go solution, because you can just recycle or throw all this packaging out when you're done with it, I think having like an on-the-go mascara might be a cool idea. So I do really like this, but I feel like I wouldn't get a lot of use out of it just with the BB cream like not being a good color match and not really helping me look like more even. So those are just like my thoughts on that if you've ever wondered about it, because I did show it around Christmas time, and those are just some of my thoughts. Okay, I used up the Cover FX Illuminating Primer Deluxe Size. I love this primer. I don't know if they make this anymore because they revamped all of their primers and everyone is going nuts about the gripping primer. And there's part of me that wants to try it, and then there's another part of me that remembers when I tried that J1, I don't know even what they call it, but it's like a sticky like primer for your face, and I'm just like feeling like what if the gripping primer is just like that, and I hated that. So if you've tried the J1 like primer, I don't even know what it's called, and you've tried the gripping primer, let me know if they're like the same type of thing. But this illuminating primer, I'm thankful I have a full size of it, so I am not without, but it's just like the perfect way to add glow under your foundation. And I think this is perfect for under especially like more matte foundations, so like Estee Lauder Double Wear or any other ones. That's just like the one I have. I just really love it. I think that it's really nice, and I would definitely repurchase if they sold it. I finished up, or I'm getting rid of, a few mascaras. Well, I have two in here. Both of these transferred on me, and I'm really, really sad that the Essence Lash Princess False Lash Effect transferred on me, because so many of you guys have recommended it to me. I've seen in so many people's videos talking about how great it is. This made me look like a raccoon by the end of the day, and I like the wand. I think that it's really nice, and if you don't have major issues with mascara transferring on you, maybe this could work for you, but this just did not work for me. And then the Milk Kush mascara, I liked this a lot, but again with the transferring. So the wand is ginormous, and how I used it was actually like backwards. I would take my hand on the opposite side and do my mascara on the opposite eye, and it would just help to give it a better effect, because I felt like this huge part where it would be at the end of your lashes just didn't do much for my outer corner lashes. So that's how I used it, but I wouldn't purchase that. Then I used up two liquid liners. This is really sad because I really love this. The Maybelline Master Precise All Day Liquid Liner Pen. This is just a deluxe size I got in an Ulta gift with purchase. And I think this is amazing. I think, did I order it? No, I ordered a different liquid liner I've been wanting to try in an Ulta order, but I would definitely recommend this and repurchase for a drugstore liner. I thought it was awesome. It doesn't get the best reviews, but it's just really easy to apply and make a nice wing, and it didn't transfer into my crease, which is like my number one problem. And then this, there's still some product in here, but I've had this for a year, or just about a year, or a little over a year. It's the NYX Matte Liquid Eyeliner, and this is in like, it's like a brush within a well of product, and it's pretty like dried out by this point. You can see how black it is, and it really does dry matte, but and I feel like I need to give this another shot because the formula is so, so good, but I just find this like little brush to be really difficult to make a perfect wing every time. It was always a struggle. I would only use this if I had time that I could fix it if it went wrong, because when it went really wrong. And this formula is so nice, but it's so long wearing that it's hard to remove. So that's something to keep in mind. If you want something that easily comes off, like, this does not do that. You definitely have to like bring an oil up into your eye area and just really go to town. But for something that lasts all day on the eyes, it's super, super nice, and you get tons of product in here. I think it is worth it. I think it's really good. The one that I ordered is the Lancome Art Liner, which is like a similar thing where it's like a brush in a well of product. So I've always wanted to try that, and I'm really happy that I'll be able to. So we'll see what I think, but those are my thoughts on those liquid liners. The last makeup thing I used up is the Milani eyeshadow primer, and there, I could cut this open, but it's like $6 and I already have a new one, so it's all good. This is definitely my favorite eyeshadow primer, and I've tried a lot over the years, but I wanted to find one at the drugstore that's inexpensive, accessible, all that good stuff. And this really does the trick for me. I use a little bit more product of this than other eye primers that I've tried. This is probably the most similar to the Urban Decay Primer Potion that I've ever found, and that used to be like my holy grail. But I use like a nice little dollop of this on both eyes, and I apply it with a brush. You could also apply it with your fingers, and it just helps my eyeshadow last all day long. Like, I don't get creasing when I use this. I always have eyeshadow crease if I do not use a primer. This prevents that. It's wonderful. It's like basically clear when you blend it out. It says number one nude, and it does look like a fair skin tone color, as you can see like on the cap. But when you blend it out, it's just like clear. So love, love, love this, and I would definitely give it a shot if you need an eye primer to make your eyeshadow last all day. Okay, on to the rest of the goodness. I used up another one of my Garnier Micellar Cleansing Waters, the waterproof blue cap one. Love this. I'm using the pink cap right now, which doesn't have like an oil phase. This has like just some micellar water and then an oil that you shake together. And I feel like a lot of people don't know that you need to shake dual phase eye makeup removers together. I remember like talking to some of my friends that aren't really into beauty and makeup, but they use like makeup remover or makeup, and I was like, make sure you shake those, and they would be like, oh my god, like I never shake it. So if you get one that has like two different layers of liquid, like be sure to shake it, because mixing those formulas together is what makes it the most effective. But I like the blue cap more than the pink cap. I would definitely repurchase this. It's similar to like the Neutrogena or like the store brand ones that have the two phases. I just really like this bottle. I like the dispenser. I like everything about it. So I would definitely repurchase. I used up the Bath & Body Works Gingerbread Latte Shower Gel. This was so nice. Oh my God, I would definitely repurchase. It's like warm vanilla sugar with a little bit of like a spice gingerbread type of scent. So really, really love that. I have so many body washes. I probably won't need to buy a body wash at all this year. So I'm trying to resist Bath & Body Works, but that's a really nice one. I had a few shampoo samples from my hair salon. So my hairstylist, Hannah, love her so much. She works at a new salon that uses Davines products. And on my hair, and probably like all of her clients' hair, when she gives like that amazing shampoo and like scalp massage, she uses the Davines Oi shampoo and conditioner. And I was able to get some samples of it. This smells like spa heaven. Like, oh my god, I hope heaven smells like this, because it is just so calming and luxurious and wonderful. I would definitely get more samples or buy the shampoo, but I don't know, I feel like most conditioners break me out. I wasn't sure if this one did, but I'd rather be safe than sorry and just get the shampoo. Really nice, cleans my hair super wonderfully, and the smell sticks with your hair. And I feel like the scent is what is the best part of that. And then I also tried the Momo shampoo for dry or dehydrated hair by Davinace, and I liked it. I liked the Oi better. Oi is more like a creamy shower shampoo, and then the Momo is more just like clear. So I felt like the Oi gave me a little more moisture, even though the Momo said it was for dry or dehydrated hair. So that was kind of interesting, but God, the smell of those is just incredible. Okay. Two boring things, let's just get them out of the way. Clear Care Contact Lens Solution. For a while, I was not using this regularly, and my eyes were so red. Like, I think that using this on a regular basis helps keep my contact lenses much cleaner, and I feel like not using this added some sort of buildup maybe to my contacts that was making my eyes really red. I don't know. So I need to buy more of this. And then my Colgate Optic White toothpaste. Love the shit out of that. Okay, lots of good stuff in here. So this I have been working on for months. This is the Hadalabo. It's all in Japanese, but this is the foaming hydrating cleanser. I love this for the shower. I originally bought this for my sister because she really likes foaming cleansers in general, and she is not someone that enjoys washing her face or doing skincare. So I was trying to like encourage her, and we just left this at our house instead of her taking it back to school. And I ended up really, really loving this and using all of it up. So you can get this on Amazon. That's the only like reputable place I've seen Hadalabo sold for US customers, and it's sent from Japan. So I feel like it's legit. I love this. I felt like this was one of the first foaming cleansers that does not dry out my skin. I definitely felt like it hydrated my skin more than most cleansers do, and I just loved how it was a pump and it foamed, super easy to do in the shower, just like brr, 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 and I would definitely repurchase. I really, really love that. Okay, I used this up. This was a surprise when nothing else, like, oh no. Okay, there's a little bit left, so I can show that to you. I thought there was like tons left in here that I just didn't get out. This is the Drunk Elephant Bee Hydra Intensive Hydration Gel. So maybe you can see it's like a gel texture. Oh my God. And then it like blends in to like a watery consistency, and it's not sticky. It's really, really nice. This was a small, like half the normal size, or yeah, this is 0.5 fluid ounces. I think the full size is an ounce or maybe even bigger. When I ordered something else, can't remember what, this was like at a reduced price if you bought it at that certain time. So I really love Drunk Elephant packaging, super wonderful, great products, really, really effective. And I just watched Daylin's video, her empties video. I'll link her channel down below. And she was talking about that now they call this a serum and it's a little more liquidy. And that intrigues me as well, because I use this as a serum, just like an extra hydration step, basically like a hyaluronic acid. But I liked how it was a gel, because a lot of the times like hyaluronic acids are really thin, and I don't know, for some reason I just like something with a little thicker of a consistency. I don't know. But I did like this. I would be interested in trying the new one. I love Drunk Elephant products, and that's all I have to say. Another brand I love is Peach and Lily. Oh my God. I could sing their praises every single day. But I used up two more of their products. I've been slowly going through a lot of their products lately. And the next product that I'm gonna start is their Matcha Moisturizer. And I ordered their new cleanser. So just like a bunch of great stuff from their brand, but I used up the Good Acids Pore Toner and the Glass Skin Refining Serum. So the Good Acids Pore Toner is like a slightly exfoliating but also pH balancing toner, and maybe you can see a little bit. I couldn't get that little bit out, but it's like a blue color. It's just a liquid, like a water. And it just has like an opening here. It's super easy to either put in your hands for like if you like to pat toners or essences into your skin. I always used it on a cotton pad. I really enjoyed this. I don't know how much it did for my skin, but I enjoyed the process of using it. It's a beautiful bottle. It's a good price point for a toner, and I feel like once I use up my other like exfoliating waters, I would definitely repurchase this. I thought that it was really, really nice. It lasted me quite a few months, and I just love Peach and Lily products. I really trust them, and so even though I didn't see like huge changes in my skin, I definitely feel like it helped keep my pores clean and keep my skin smooth. And definitely the Glass Skin Refining Serum is like a staple product I will keep in my collection. I have a backup of it, but I haven't opened it yet, just trying to use up a few other things. But this just really is like the do-it-all type of serum. It's a gel consistency, not sticky, not too thin, not too thick. I can use this day or night, and I enjoy it both times of day. It layers well under moisturizers and makeup, and to me it just helps keep my skin looking really nice and smooth and hydrated. It's not like a really exfoliating serum. It has some fruit enzymes and extracts in it that help. They like work at breaking down like skin buildup, I guess. So it kind of is exfoliating, but it also has hyaluronic acid to hydrate, calm, brighten, and firm skin. So to me, this is like the perfect type of serum. I would definitely say it's more like a daytime serum to me. I like to use like oils and things like that at night, but seriously, I love this. I love the packaging. I love that it's a pump. This is plastic, and you can take this off. So I was able to like get every last drop out of this container, because even when you can't pump it anymore, there's still more in the bottom. So be sure to take that off and dump it in your hands every night or every morning. And I just love it. Definitely would recommend it. This, I have one more use left, but I wanted to show you guys. It's the J1 Hana Cream, and I got this on Glow Recipe for free, because if you sign up for the Glow Recipe like rewards program, you earn points and then you can trade them in for discounts, or this is a like reward. And this cream is worth $50. That's how much the retail price is, but you can use like 300 points and get it for free. So I got this for free. Definitely worth it. I would not spend $50 on this. But what's cool about it is that these are balls of, can I show you? There goes one. These are balls of moisturizer. I do not know how to show this to you guys. You know what like a sphere looks like. And then I always use two at once, and then I smash them in my hands and then blend them onto my skin. What's so nice about these is that they're not really heavy, but they definitely moisturize really, really nicely. So it just blends in so effortlessly. It has like a powdery scent. It's kind of strong, but nothing like offensive. And it just sinks into your skin really, really fast. So now it is completely empty. But I would say I got a good 2 to 3 months out of this, and I use two every night. So there's definitely good value in here. I feel like it's more of a fun type of product than actually like being worth $50 to me. Like, I don't think the formula is that much different or better. It's nice. I liked it. I would use it again if I got another free one, but it's not my favorite nighttime moisturizer. But the sphere thing, that's just so innovative and cool. Like, I was hoping that I could just use one, because then it would have lasted forever. My perfect amount would have been 1.5 spheres, but I just used 2 because I was like, what the heck? Okay, I used this the other week and I can't take it. It's the Glam Glow Super Mud Clearing Treatment. This burned my face so much. I have not used this in a long time. I used to get like more clay masks and things like that more often in the past, but I tried this, I applied it on just my T-zone, and it burned so much I like immediately washed it off. So I will not be purchasing any like mud mask, salicylic acid, stuff like that. My skin just can't take it. Then I have just 2 last products. The Sol de Janeiro Boom Boom Cream. I always thought it was Bum Bum, but I've learned that it's Boom Boom. This was just a really small size I got in a Sephora Favorites kit. This, it smells amazing, of course. But to me, it just smells like a Bath & Body Works more vanilla sugar. Like, it's not a super unique scent. It smells great, like, don't get me wrong. But I wouldn't... It just isn't worth the price to me, like, bottom line. Really nice formula. I liked how it felt, loved how it smelled, but I'm not gonna buy expensive moisturizers at this point in my life. And then the last thing, oh my god, so sad, is my Jo Malone Wood Sage and Sea Salt little deluxe size. So I have a 1 fluid ounce bottle now. Love it so much. This is like, oh my god, this and Prada Candy are the only fragrances I feel like I need. This is like the sexiest, coziest, like, oh, just so interesting. It's like creamy, creamy is the word. Oh my god. It just makes me feel like I'm enveloped in a hug. Like, it smells so good to me. Every time I wear it, I just smell my wrist and I'm like, oh my god, I'm in love. Like, I adore this scent, and I know some of you guys have picked it up since I've been raving about it. And if you've never smelled it, smell it. It's so good. I think you would really, really enjoy it. And it was one of my like Christmas presents to myself to get a full size of it. And I just adore it. So I used up this little one. I didn't want to because I enjoyed having it in my purse, but there was so little left. And now I have the full size that I was like, okay, it's time. So that is everything in my empties for the month of February. Somehow these videos are still super long, even though I feel like I mean, this is a good amount of stuff, but you know, sometimes I just have like mountains of empties in my videos. This is just like a nice, normal amount, but I could talk forever. So I hope you guys enjoyed this. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you really soon. Bye.